Hey there, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to perform cost estimation using Navisworks Timeliner feature. We'll start from the export of the Revit model until we get to the creation of a 5D simulation in Navisworks. So we'll start by downloading a Revit model. You can go to this link, it's added in the description below, where you're going to find the structural model, this one, and we will just download it. Next, we will open it in Revit. There it is. And now we will export it to NWC format so we can use it in Navisworks. There are two ways to do this. First, you can simply go to File, Export NWC. Or you can just go to Add-ins, External Tools, and Navisworks 2023 in my situation. Now we'll just give it a name. Cost estimation example, and most importantly we'll go to the Navisworks settings, make sure that we converted the element IDs, parameters, properties, that the coordinates are project internal, that we have exported the entire project, and then we'll just go and hit OK and save. We'll wait for the export, and then we will fast forward to launching Navisworks and then appending our model. Make sure that you have the NWC format selected in the types of files below, and then we'll open it. And that's our model in Navisworks. First, we have to remove the guy with a hard hat. So we'll just go to viewpoints, realism, and enable third person. And it's time to start using our Timeliner tool. Go back to home, check Timeliner. You can either pin it or unpin it by the pin on the right side of the screen. Okay, so in terms of tasks, you can import your tasks or import your data from a CSV import, Microsoft Project, or Primavera. But for this tutorial, I'm simply going to add a task by task by simply saying add task. Next, we have the selection tree, which will help us select elements for each task. I have created a video in which I have explained all of these steps very precisely, so you can watch it if you have a CSV import or a different type of import. But for now, we gave a name to our task. You have to make sure that you have chosen the planned start and planned end of the task. Then the type of the task, for this example, it's going to be constructing, not demolishing. And then we have total cost, material cost, labor cost, equipment cost, and sub-constructor cost. Well, in the default view, you won't get these, so you just go to columns and then choose columns. And then simply check these elements with these columns, which are the ones we're going to be using for the cost estimation process. I've already done that in my previous projects that I've worked on. Okay, now I'm going to explain the process of the selection using the selection tree, which is either by selecting elements this way simply or by creating the sets. So you have selected elements, we'll go to attached and then simply attach the selected elements. The other example, let's create a new task, for example, for columns. Columns. Okay. As usual, add the planned test and the end test. The end start, the planned end and the planned start. The type of the task, and then now we will attach the selection. So we'll do the same thing as before. But then we'll go to sets, manage sets, and then create a new set and give it the same name of the elements that we have chosen. Now we'll go back to attached, right click, and then we will find attach sets and choose the only set that we have created. These are the two methods that you can use to select or to attach 3D elements to your task. So in the simulation, it will know which elements are being constructed during this task. I'm gonna fast forward and create the rest of the tasks that we're gonna be needing. I made sure to choose a structural model because that would be less complex. We can create the least tasks possible. And now we will go to the cost estimation process. So there's total cost, which is the column in which the sum of the of all the other costs is being counted. I am adding random costs to the material, the labor, just to show you how it works. And that's it. We have created the costs of our project. Now we'll go to simulate. So the thing that we need the most is going to the settings and then overlay text and edit it. So I'm going to remove all of these and take you back to the default view, which is the one that you will find if this is your first time performing this, and show you how to change it. Let's press OK, OK, and there we are. So this is what you will see usually in a 4D simulation, which is a simulation that has only the time as the fourth dimension, but we need the fifth dimension, which is the cost. If, for example, I want to change the color of the text to red, let's say, and then type budget. Budget equals, and then go to cost. I can add material cost, labor cost, subcontractor cost. For this one, I'm going to simply add the total cost of the project. Add the dollar sign and then go, for example, to extra, choose what more I want to add to my simulation. For example, the currently active task or the percentage of the task that's being accomplished. I can also change the font of the text, I can change the time zone and the date and time, I can even change the format of the time. Now we'll press OK, this is fine for now. There we are, our preferences has changed, and then we'll press play. And we can simply visualize the 5D simulation of our project being constructed. Now, if I want to export this simulation, I'll just go to animation export and just press OK. And yeah, that's it. That's how you perform cost estimation using Navisworks. If you're interested in this type of content, you can watch the whole playlist, which shows all the tools of Navisworks, how to use them, and what's the difference between each one of them. Yeah, if you like the video, like and subscribe. And obviously, thank you for watching.